going to show you about how I went to connect the 240 volt prong. The ground cable is connected to the rail. There are two prongs coming from the 240. The red one is one face, second face is the black one, and that's the medium. I went ahead and ringed the ground layer from this side to right here using a black cable. The contactors are all down. So each contactor has 240 volts. This is one face and this is the second face. So it's all equally distributed. And these two cables on the top are controlled using the relay to make the contactors work. The relay's power is cut short using these two switches, and they'll be used to control the laser source and chiller, and they're getting the power source using from the 240 volts. This small power supply is at 24 volts. The 24 volts supplies the control panel. Not forgetting that the bigger panel here, 15 volt, it's equipped to still power the control panel too. You're going to join me for a quick build. I'll be connecting the handheld part cables. I'll be connecting them to the control board. Together with that, I'll be connecting the cable coming from the wire feeder. Okay, here we go. So we can go ahead and start wiring. I'm going to start with the yellow cable. Yellow cable is going to go to the D negative. So what we are wiring here is the wire feeder machine cable. So the next one, we're going to go to the green one. The green one always goes to the positive. The next one will be the P negative. P negative is the white one. Next one will be the brown. It goes to the positive. And these are the two cables that are supposed to go to the 24 volts positive and negative. So I might have to splice here. I'll update you what I do about it. The next item on the list is the ground cable for the laser head. So this is where you either grab on material or you grab on the tip when you are doing the CNC work or when you clean. So it's supposed to go right here. I currently don't have a way to snip it, a way to hook up this, so I'm going to chop it. and I'm going to use a to do the connection at this point. It's well compressed. It has a zip tie. I don't want to do the zip tie at this moment, but I'll just put it here for the time being. I'll put it all the way in and tighten it. Let me grab the next item. I was able to go ahead and connect the razor head. As you can see, the piping is splitted into two. So the coolant comes through here, split into two. One goes to the head and one is left in the QBH. The orange cable, this one, orange line is a air, is a pneumatic line. It will be carrying either compressed air or nitrogen. I went ahead and connected these two connections right here. So they actually three connections. The first connection here, this comes from the switch, and the rest goes to the optics. So it has a optic stabilizer, and it's more like how your phone camera works. It has a stabilizer and for different mirrors, and within different functionality of it, you can do laser cleaning and welding and cutting. So that's why it has two cables coming out of it. So this refined technology of laser stabilization. So as you can see, there's one wrench right here and second wrench right there, and this is where the attachment of the welding cable goes through, and the cable passes through this small groove right here. And by the time this the wire gets to the tip point, that's where the welding happens. The bottom feels comfortable. The design of the arm is ergonomic. And at the moment, I'm not connecting this part to here because this is a critical point in optics of laser. You have to be dust free just to open it. By the time I'm getting to connect there, I need to ensure there's not even a speck of dust particle in there, otherwise it's going to damage the crystal. So I have ultraviolet light. It doesn't have batteries at the moment. This is what you use to inspect dust particles. I'm going to walk you through that procedure. Then after that, we are going to go ahead and connect it. So once we connect this side, I won't open it anymore. It will be a permanent fix. And I'm going to thread this cable cover all the way to the top right there and zip tie it, or however I'm going to manage the cable. Then after that, this new domains will be properly fixed. All the excess cable will be well managed and left in there. Other from that, the other thing I would wish to show you, this is what you use to do the cleaning of the the tip of the crystal, which is on the QBH. These are isopropyl alcohol
The content of it, percentage wise, is 99%, and it's so specific on what kind of absorbent you use to carry out the cleaning. So I have here cotton swabs. It has to be cotton so that it gets in residues. It has to be specially made for the posterior use, pure cotton.
Adios, amigos.